Pinterest is an incredible website that you can use for pretty much anything, but the one specific thing that I love to use Pinterest for is to find either inspiration images for houses or floor plan inspiration for my houses and apartments. And today we're going to be recreating an image that I've already found on Pinterest. I'll pop it up somewhere here for you so that you can sort of see what our plan is. And we're going to be recreating this in The Sims 4. So the apartment that I've chosen is 2A Jasmine Suites in San Myshuno, and essentially what we're going to be doing to achieve the look of our little New York City inspired floor plan is we're going to section off this just over half of the apartment, and we're going to raise a platform all the way up. So essentially all the space that we have to work with is right here. Now the reference image is just on my right monitor, so if you see me looking over there, that is exactly what I'm doing. So on the reference image, it looks as though there's like a built-in wardrobe here, so we'll try and figure that out in just a minute. And then the bathroom is right here. But then what we're going to have is we're going to have this odd sort of space, so I might raise a platform up here as well. So that's that. And then we've got this space to work with for the kitchen, living room, and then the bedroom. But this looks pretty accurate and what the actual image looks like so far. So let's add some lights in here so that we can actually see what we're doing, because we're working with such a small space and I'm thinking, okay. So let's have a look and see if we've got a built-in wardrobe to add here. First of all, I'm thinking of the one from, is it this one here? Oh, it's not gonna fit. Oh yes, it is. Oh, it just fits. Okay, so that, I'm assuming that's just for some extra storage space, because I can't imagine that we're gonna be able to fit a wardrobe in the bedroom area. So that's actually a really good use of the space. Then what we've got all the way down here is we've got some kitchen cabinets. So let's go ahead and choose some of them. I'm thinking of using these ones from the new Home Chef Hustle pack, although I haven't really decided on a color scheme for this apartment yet. So maybe we could just use some like placeholder items first of all, and then we can always add some bits and pieces. So this is actually going to be really difficult, and I'm going to have to, I don't want to put the fridge there because we do have a window, so I'm going to add the fridge here instead. So let's just pop a fridge in there, and then it looks as though the cooker is over here, so let's add the cooker. I like this one from the Cool Kitchen Stuff Pack, so I think I might add that there. And then the sink is here, which means I'm just going to have to leave that counter space completely free so that your Sims can actually prepare their food, which normally, if I had more counter space, I would be cluttering the heck out of this right now, but I cannot do that with this apartment, which is fine. It's just a little bit upsetting, but I'll get over it. It's okay. So, and then I'm going to leave that free because I don't want to block off the window. Let me just see if I can add, we could add that perhaps. That kind of works. Okay. Yes. Let's do that. What I might end up doing is I might just add some like placeholder items initially until we can work out what sort of floor plan we want to go for, but I might not, because I'm actually quite happy with that kitchen, and then we can just add some pops of color here and there to make things look a little bit more interesting. So I'm already leaning towards a sofa that I've used a million and one times, but it's this one from the Book Nook kit. I really like it, and then it means that we can put the bed here. And I think with this apartment, I'd like to keep it quite colorful because we're not going to have a lot of space. I don't want it to be like this really bland, boring like unit. I think it could still be really nice even though we've got like no space whatsoever. So let's add that there, and then grab these from Dream Home Decorator. Which color should we go with? I actually really like these in this swatch. I think that looks really good. Okay, a little bit tight on space, but it's fine. It's not a problem. And then for curtains, I'm thinking of the Modern Looks pack. I think these could be nice. So let's add them. Oops, come on either side. But then we've got an issue with this. So we might just have to add one curtain and then just like a curtain rail going across, which I don't necessarily want to do. Is there another way around this? Have we got some different kerns that we can use? There must be. These from Seasons. We're gonna have the same. Oh, it just skims. I'm thinking we need a different bed. Is there a different bed that we can use that's a bit more... not interesting, just something different. No, I don't think that's gonna work. What about this one? I don't feel like this bed comes in like a... oh, it does, but... which ones did Dream Home Decorator come with? Let me have a look and see which ones Dream Home Decorator came with. Oh yeah, okay. So we could keep on with the green theme, but are we gonna be having a bit too much green in here? Maybe, but we can worry about that in just a moment. So there is a chair here as well, which I really like. So I'm going to add a little chair over there. I like that one from Dream Home Decorator as well, actually. I think that looks pretty good. So that's there. Then it looks as though we've got a TV unit right here, but I don't know what this is in front of the window. So let's see what we can. So we could put that as the coffee table, which means that we can match the bedside cabinets. I think that's a really good idea. And then for the TV unit, perhaps we can do the same thing, just to make sure everything matches really well. So for the TV, I think we should just go for maybe this one here. Okay. Well, we've put everything in. Obviously, I know we need to do the bathroom. Oh, and actually, it's a small bathroom, so I think we should probably do that. That probably makes more sense. This is pretty much looking like the floor plan on the right-hand side. So I'm probably going to stop looking at that now and actually just start making this look a little bit less boring and a little bit more colourful. So I think we need to try some colour schemes. Although, hold on, let me see. What am I doing? There. I do like that one. That door's awful, but we're not really going to see too much of it, so I'm not too worried about it. It's fine. Let's see. In terms of the flowerbots, I love these, but I think they're probably a bit too rustic for wanting to achieve here. So let's I actually don't mind that, but it's a bit too chestnutty wood for me. Oh yes, that's much better. Ooh, yeah, okay. I'd see, if it was me, I'd put the TV unit here, but that just makes no sense really, so I don't want to be doing that. And they don't have a dining room table either, so we can't put anything like that in. But I think I already know which rug I want to use, and if anyone can guess before I pull it out, which you probably can, because it's my favourite rug in the entire game at the moment, unless something comes along and takes its place, which I can't see happening anytime soon. I love that so much. So let's just go ahead and put a lamp perhaps on. I might not put a lamp on that one because it's gonna clip. So I might just have to put like a plant or something over there. A small plant it's gonna have to be, because yes. We need a plant over here, speaking of plants, but maybe we'll size that down just so it takes up less of the space. But I'm thinking as well, we could put like, there's a standing lamp that came with Growing Together that I absolutely adore. So we could put that there. Right, I think that looks pretty good. Oh, maybe we need like a pop of orange to tie in the rug. Let's see what orange chairs we have. We've got some with Growing Together, but I don't really like them. We've got this one, but I don't really think it's fitting with the vibe. So let me filter by color. Got orange, and see if there's perhaps another one that we can pick out. So we do have this one. Ooh, I actually don't mind that there. No, because like, why does that look so good? Not to toot my horn or anything, but yeah, I'm actually really liking this color scheme. It's not a color scheme that I even thought about when I was deciding like which color scheme to go for this little apartment, but it's actually working out quite well. Let's put that above the bed. We're gonna need something relatively small, but that's quite sweet. Although I'm kind of thinking that I want some color, but we do have some green there, so maybe we don't need color. Now let's go to everyday clutter kit and see if there's anything that we can add to the bedside table here, such as like maybe a pair of glasses, and maybe we can add some fitness stuff. as well, because perhaps this Sim is super into fitness and keeping healthy, because I think that's, these aren't things that I would normally add to my Sims builds, but let's just go for something completely different with this, and this is what I'm going with. So that's that. And I think adding clutter to such small spaces makes things super interesting. Ooh, should we add, is that gonna look strange just above the sofa? Possibly, but I feel like you wouldn't be able to hang your stuff anywhere else, really, would you? You'd probably have to have something like that, I feel. So let's go with yes. Okay, I actually really like this so far. And is there anything else that we maybe want? Should we put like a little water bottle next to the bed? I think that could be quite cute. I love this plan so much. Okay, yes, that's going right there. It just is, because it has to. So do we go super simple? I'm gonna add some tiling behind the kitchen units, but do we just go really simple and try and open up the space a little bit? I think that might be a good idea. We could go cream just to warm it up. Let's do that. And then let's pick out a tile. Maybe we could pick out like a really fun one. Although I do like this one that came with the new stuff pack. The Home Chef Hustle stuff pack. Yes, that is what it's called. Although, is there a... Ooh, okay, there is a turquoise, but is that just a little bit much? It possibly is. Well, what about that? It kind of ties in quite nicely. See, I don't know, I always feel like this space is so void now. Maybe we should, move these up just one. I know that sounds really silly. Excuse me. They're really silly, but I like it. I do like it. Okay. And then I'm thinking of just keeping these white, just keeping things super, super simple. And then we're going to add like a teeny tiny little rug just in front of the cooker, because why do I like doing this? I have no idea, but I really like doing it. So it's getting added. I don't like that one. No, that's getting gone. Which one do we want? I think there's one from Base Game that we could maybe have in an orange swatch. I think it's this one. Yeah, it's this one, but size it down one and then do that. Ooh, and then from the Home Chef Hustle stuff pack, we've got some stuff that we can put on the wall, I think. So it's this. This is what I was thinking of. Oh, I love that. That's so cute. It's probably a fire hazard, but I don't want to say I don't care. I just don't care. And then I really want to add something in the corner. If I add something in the corner, like a plant, will your Sim still be able to prepare the meal? I've got a funny feeling it's no, but I might playtest it and see, because I just feel like it needs something over in that corner. It just does. I'm sorry. I don't care. It just needs something. Let me see. What am I looking for? Oh yeah, plant. So the... Help. Blooming rooms! That's what I was thinking of. I was thinking there's like a really tiny... There, look. We just need that in the corner. You tell me we do not need this. Don't come for me. We really need this in the corner. We don't, but we do. Like, we just really need it. We do need a bin. Oh my gosh. Okay, it's about to ruin the whole aesthetic, but I'm hoping your Sims are going to be able to prepare their food there. Please tell me they're going to be able to. I'm going to play test this before I put it up on the gallery, by the way, so please don't panic at all. It's going to be fine. I never know what to do with this window here. Normally it's not too bad because there's one on the other side, but we've blocked that off. So perhaps we just need to add a little blind. I think that could work, actually. and I quite like it in the darker swatch because it ties in with the floor and it just makes it look super warm and welcoming in here. And then I know that someone is going to come for me, but I might put a rug underneath the bed. But I don't know why. Like, why am I putting a rug underneath the bed? It makes no sense. I might put a circular rug because then it doesn't look as... Oh, see, that does not look good. No, 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 no. Okay. Is that... Do you know what? I might not... Oh, should we put that on a bit of an angle? Like that? Is that weird? Maybe. But I actually really like that. I think that looks cute. Look, we could hang some clothes here. Look. Oh. Can we... Oh, there. My gosh, they're hard to snap on. Right. Oh, see, I quite like that because, look, it looks like we're making use of the space. And then we can put some trinkets in here and stuff. How cute. Okay, okay, which means I might do this, but in a different swatch. So, like... Oh, that could kind of work, although... Is that weird if we add like a pink one? Or does it kind of tie in? Look at the orange in there. Matches the orange in the rug. See, it's just all coming together. It's all coming together. And I've also just realized there's like the most perfect like little thing in the book nook kit. I'm gonna show you it right now. Here it is, look. And I think I might swap everything out. Wait, they can go there. Can we just take a minute, please? Like, look how cute this is. Okay, so for the floor plan here, we actually have a bath here, but I'm going to add, oh, and the door's actually over here. I'm going to add a bath shower combination so that it's a little bit more of a usable space. And I am gonna use this one from Growing Together because I really like it. Please tell me that's gonna, thank goodness. I thought there was gonna be an issue. I thought there was gonna be issues. Right, the toilet is here and then the sink is directly next to it. So we'll just add that. Although, no. We'll go for the tiny living one. I never use that. And then Growing Together also came with a really nice sink. So I think we're gonna add that just there. Okay, let's add a very quick mirror. I'm gonna add this one from Tiny Living because I think it would be silly not to. And then I'm going to use the same tiles from the kitchen in here, but I am going to use different ones for the floor. I'm going to use these ones, I think. I'm saying that so reluctantly, so hesitant. would these ones from High School Years work in like the gray? No, we need more of like a simple, maybe that. Let's go with that. Let's just go with that. So this is our final product. I'll flash the reference image on screen for you so that you can see sort of how we did. I think we pretty much nailed it. I think we nailed the floor plan and the style that I wanted to go for. I think it looks really good. So essentially what you do is you come into the apartment. We have the full bathroom just on the left here. Then we have our kitchen area, which I think turned out really well. I will play test this, as I said, before I put it on the gallery to make sure you Sim can actually prepare a meal on here. But then if we spin around, we have our living area, we've got a TV, and then we have our like little bedroom area as well. We've got a beautiful view outside of our windows, and I'm loving the vibes of this apartment. I think it looks really cozy. I really hope you enjoyed this video. If there are any more floor plans that you would like me to check out on the channel, please drop me some ideas and comments down below. But I really hope you enjoyed this. You all take care, and I will see you again next time. Bye.